Hello, everyone! I am Tacit, and today I'm going to be going over all 16 campaign tasks for the Seal of Carandera Chapter 2 Golvania event. So, this week we're going to do it a little bit differently as far as the order, and probably keep this order going forward. All the things for the teams and tasks, as always, will be in the description below, as well as pinned to the video. But we're going to be going in a slightly different order. We're going to be starting with the teams, just to kind of give a general idea of what you could be using for the battles, because since there's so much overlap with a couple of them, probably makes a little bit more sense that way, since you've kind of would already know what to do going into them. Then we're going to go over each of the 16 tasks in the same order as always, going to bronze, silver, and then gold, and then talking about when or what you end up getting and when you'll be able to get the rewards if you're playing free to play. So let's go and get into that. So first things first, teams. We're going to start with this time around. Again, all these in description, so you can just copy paste them. So for a good majority of these tasks, you can, as always, use a quick kill Rowain team. The specific one use Doomed Club. However, you can use any club in the game there as an alternative. Doomed Club is just the strongest. Rowain, Leprechaun, and Mirage Queen is the rest of the team, pretty much as a relatively standard quick kill Rowain team. This is used, obviously, for a good majority of battles, as this is still pretty much the quickest way to kill things consistently, and has a whole slot that you can replace with pretty much whatever. Banner might look a little bit weird, but we need it for one of the tasks, so that's why I believe one of the gold tasks end up using it. For this one, we had to use a pure Golvania for one of them, so we ended up going with a Mountain Crusher Mana Accumulator, which has to be set to Death Knight, because that makes it count as Golvania, and then you basically just use any true damage full AoE. One of the bats that are low rarity there could work, though Crimson Bat is a bit more consistent, and you can just run that on a low explore, and you run the goal simply to have the extra stone link to get your Mountain Crusher up quicker. And for the next one, for the silver, we have to accumulate a bunch of purple for one of the tasks, so one of the easiest way to do this is giant spider into a bunch of thralls and just keep looping that back and forth. I did use a more expensive variant of this where I did the same premise but with Vespera, but of course if you need something cheap, giant spider with thralls works perfectly fine for it. For the next silver one, we had to go and accumulate a bunch of souls. There's a lot of ways to do this. I personally did it with four Ferish Rods. You could do it with single Ferish Rod to Phylactery team, with a Sacrificial Priest. You can use Dragon Soul double Ferish Rod. This one I tried going a little bit cheaper for, without going the absolute cheapest. Absolute cheapest would be something like a bunch of Warlocks with Valkyrie or something along those lines, but it's kind of more of a mid-range one that isn't like the absolute slowest, but still a little bit more accessible without going into any mythics, which ends up working out pretty well for it. Also use a Necromancer Hero class in case you need a little bit extra. And for the Silver 4, you basically just use get it passively because you have to kill a bunch of Grey Kings. You can just do it passively through the Ward Lore event. Otherwise, you could just go and spam Golvania, and you will eventually on Explore 12 get a bunch of with your normal Explore team for Explore 12, and just run that until you just get a bunch of Grey Kings in Golvania. But those are basically the general teams that you'll be able to need for the following tasks. So let's go now into the task system. So first things first, Bronze 1. Win 4 battles using the Death Knight Hero class. This is very easy. You can use this literally anywhere. Just use Death Knight Hero class and just quick kill any explore. Given the overlap, you'd most likely want to do it in Golvania so that you can start killing undead enemies, which you'll be needing for the gold task. Pretty much a good majority of these you will want to do in Golvania at a very low difficulty, like difficulty 2. For the next one, Bronze 2, Dungeon Lord. Win 3 dungeon battles. So this is pretty easy. You would automatically get this done simply by doing your dailies. Generally speaking, especially when it goes to a beginning of a week, you actually want to make sure you don't do any of your dailies, because quite a few of these tasks, if you're doing them all specifically on a Monday, which we normally do on the Monday night streams, you'll want to make sure you don't touch these, because a good majority of the time there will be something in these tasks that will require them. Both weeks now, we have had a dungeon requirement, one which only took one day and one that took 2 days, with the 2 days being the first time around, and this time being one day. But anyways, this is pretty straightforward. Just clear through dungeons with whatever you normally kill through dungeons with, and you'll be good to go. Next task, win 1 explore run in Golvania at difficulty 2 or higher. Again, this is why we stick to Golvania. A lot of these have overlap here. Just simply go through the entirety of it, and one whole run does count as every single one of the battles up to either the mini boss or the mythic boss, depending on if you have enough shards or not. So simply just clear through all of those, and that will count regardless of what team you use it with. Just run a quick kill team. Next one, win 4 battles using a mace weapon. Similarly, you can run this. I ended up doing it with the Doomed Club. However, you can do it with any mace weapon in the game. Maces are specifically the category underneath the hero weapons, where if you go underneath weapons and then click over here to specifically the type of mace, anything underneath this category, where on earth is mace, there it is, anything underneath this category will work, with the strongest option, of course, if you happen to have it being a Doomed Club. Next up, for next task. Completes 30 turns in one treasure hunt. Now, this was the one a lot of people struggled with this week. It is only 50 gems to repick these. I would not normally advise to do so. But I feel like this was the biggest one people had trouble with, even though it was only on bronze. To do this, you would, of course, just need to use a treasure map. Some strategies that you can use here is you can keep repicking your treasure maps if you have a lot of them. And if you don't see like a 5 times off the starting board, just retreat. Go right back in, and you can keep doing this until you get like a really good starting board. And this will give you a lot more of an advantage going forward. But anyways, some general strategy for this. You normally want to take your extra turns from the highest and then work your way to the lowest. You do want to prioritize 5 times first, more often than not, though, as a 5 times is much better value, and you do want to go for those. But priority order is basically take 5 times, take extra turns from the top, and then work your way to the bottom, because if you take one from the bottom, you might ruin one of them that are on the top. For example, taking this move up right now or to the left will likely make it so we cannot take this move, so you do want to be wary of that. Keeping a lot of a single type on the board is a good way to get turns up. For example, gold coins are normally a really good option for that. From the bottom three rows, right down here, you normally want to make sure going into the map. No, don't waste a bunch of turns for it, but you normally want to make sure these three rows are basically removed all of the bronze and silver coins. These can end up blocking you the most down here, since you tend to put all your bigger resources here, and then they won't be able to combine into anything, which will make it so you'll end up losing the map. You don't want to overwaste your turns to try to get rid of these. However, you do at some point over the progression of the map want to get them removed so that you're able to get the really high score count. And other than that, you do want to prioritize setting up for 5 times. So using a turn and then getting a 5 times rather than taking a 4 times is much better than simply taking a 4 times. Of course, there are many times where you are simply going to have to take the 4 times off the board, but it is much better to set up into a 5 times, as it will give you much better overall value, since you're basically getting 2 turns for the exact same score of only getting one single turn progression. But anyways, you basically just complete out the map, go and try to get 60, and that is the whole premise there. I'm not going to do the whole thing here, because obviously that takes a little bit of time and may take more than one attempt. But if you need to, it is skippable for 50 gems. I would not advise it, but it is possible to do so. It is a bronze task, so it's not like it was under silver or gold. Silver's cost 100 to repick, and gold 150. And when I say repick, I mean it actually instantly gets it done, so you don't need to worry about it then. Anyways, next one. Next bronze task. Complete a delve at level 30 or higher. So this is pretty straightforward. You just go to, you can camp level 20 though. So best way to do this is go to City of Thieves. Assuming that you don't camp it at level 20, go to City of Thieves at level 50, and simply just quick kill this out with any kind of rowing team, whatever you feel like using. Obviously, we have this right over here, but whatever rowing team you want to use, kill it out, boom, you got it done. And you just go through the first battle, one to fives, and then into the final battle. You could theoretically do this in any delve, however, City of Thieves has the highest loot. Also, you can do every single room if you want, however, rushing straight to the end is, of course, the quickest way of getting it done. Next up, open 2 event chests. This is pretty straightforward. Go to chests, open 2 event keys, good to go. If you haven't already bought in them, Spoils of War every single week can be bought underneath the shop menu, underneath the resources page, all the way to the left. There is a Spoils of War thing, which costs glory, which you can buy up to 10 for per week. It's not currently here because I already got it this week. However, you simply go and buy up that, and you'll easily be able to go get 2 event keys for 360 glory total. So very easy to go get those if you happen to be sitting on 0 event keys. Next, complete all battles and a single adventure board. So this is pretty straightforward as well. Go over to adventure board and simply do all 3 of the tasks on a given day, and that will end up giving you the reward for that bronze. Next up, win 4 battles using a Galvania team. So this you can do wherever you want. Mentioned this team earlier, since we are going over to teams first, but simply just go over to any explore battle and quick kill it with a nice Galvania team. Easiest way to do this is with Mountain Crusher and then anything that can one-shot the entire team. You can do this on a really low explore difficulty, like 1, 2, 3, and just simply one-shot it. You can do this with any of the full AoEs that exist within this kingdom, Crimson Bat being one of the more optimal ones, though there are cheaper alternatives, but anything that will hit all enemies and a single cast and win. And the ghouls are just here for the extra brown support to get Mountain Crusher up quicker in case you need another cast, in case any of them revive in the given explore that you're doing, though of course you can always choose an explore that has no chance to revive on you. And lastly, for the 10th one, defeat 13 blue enemies. This is pretty straightforward. Just use any kind of Rowain team or any quick kill team, go to an explore. One of the better explores for this would be some kind of place like Merlantis or Stormheim, basically anywhere that has a lot of blues, And just fight them a few times, boom, and you'll get all the blue kills you need and move on from there. So, silver tasks. Silver's first task, craft 3 purple summoning stones. So we have to use one of these the other week, and it looks like they're finally making us use this mechanic. So summoning stones is something you don't tend to really use beyond the first couple hundred hours of the game, but it looks like they're forcing us to have to do it now, which might be bad for some people since you kind of need these to craft weapons. However, this week it wants you to craft 3 purple summoning stones. These are purple summoning stones, and you'd have to get 3 of them, and they just give various drops based on the week. Nothing really too over the top this week. Normally they're pretty bad drops. They're only really good if you're trying to find like a really key epic to try to like get a kingdom upgrade or something, but for the most part you don't really touch these since this material is needed to craft weapons. However, every single campaign so far has required you to open at least one of these, which will waste those resources, which is kind of unfortunate. You could of course use gems to skip this, however the value of this is worth less than 100 gems, so I'd probably just use the material since it would cost you 100 gems to skip this silver task. Anyway, second silver task, match 300 purple gems. So this is pretty straightforward. You'd go wherever you want, doesn't matter where, and simply just run a team that can generate for a lot of purple. With the example I gave earlier, you just run triple throw into giant spider and you'll be good to go. You'll get all the purple you need very quickly, and yeah, and then you'll get all of them in a single battle. Only take like a minute or two, and be very easy. Next, earn 400 souls. Similarly, you can go wherever you want. Use a standard soul farming team. Doesn't matter what, as long as you can get a lot of souls, you will need to go and get 400 total, so ideally having Ferris Roz is very helpful. However, even without Ferris Roz, it would probably only take a few minutes to accumulate that many souls, and all the bonuses you get do count towards it, as long as they're a result of a battle, so you can get that up pretty quickly. And plus, there's a bunch of troops that have Necromancy, and you can just end up using those to boost you up as well if you don't have something like a Ferris Ra to assist you. Finally, defeat 3 Grey Kings. This is, oddly enough, probably the hardest one to actually do, even though it's underneath Silver. There are 2 different ways to go about this. For one, you could do it in Golvania underneath Explore 12 by constantly spamming Explore 12, by clearing this out and then going to 12, and then every single time you get a Mythic boss, there will be a chance that it will end up being a Grey King, and you have to do that 3 times in order to kill it. There are 2 other alternatives. The best way of ideally doing it is for the World Lore event that we had going on this week, and we still have going on for another 10 hours and 31 minutes. That's not it. But for the Riddles in the Dark, there is a Grey King that keeps showing up every several battles, and you would easily be able to get it done passively throughout. But alternatively, one of the other ways that you can end up doing it is going to PvP. So while it's not exceedingly common to see a Grey King, you can constantly keep repicking underneath casual PvP until it only costs 50 gold here each time to do it under casual PvP, and just keep doing it until you find Grey King in the thumbnail. And as you can see, there are 2 Grey Kings here, and both of these 2 Grey Kings will count as Grey King kills. So if you can get really lucky and find people who are setting whatever the event thing is for the given week by doing this method like we just did with a double Grey King, this will help you out substantially, because this would be the absolute quickest method to do it. Currently, people aren't really setting a lot of whatever the objective troop is, mostly because they're generally high rarity things like Grey King this week. However, people will catch on as we keep getting more and more campaigns, and it is going to be increasingly likely as more campaigns go by that we will be able to get really lucky with things like this, which will allow this task to be done in a matter of seconds, because right here we would have gotten 2 out of our 3 Grey King kills in pretty much a minute simply by going and killing this out with whatever normal PvP team we want to go and use. So definitely keep an eye out for that. And yeah, easiest, quickest way to get it done. Though getting it done passively through the event is the next best method. And worst comes to worst, you could just grind it in Golvania just by doing Explore 12 for like half an hour or less. But you'd get a bunch of tokens along the way, so it's not a complete waste of time. Lastly, the 2 gold tasks. We have to kill 44 undead enemies. You've probably been doing Golvania Delve or Explore enough that you probably already killed it. Not to mention the World Lore event would already give you a bunch of undead kills, as the World Lore event will generally have really high synergy with whatever the tasks are. And other than that, you have to win 22 battles with Vampire Banner, and the easiest way to do that is go to any Explore and quick kill while using that one red purple banner. And obviously, as many things, you just simply run a Rowane team, quick kill. That's why we had the weird banner here, and simply do that 22 times, and boom, you'd be able to get that done within like 5 minutes or less or so. So pretty easy, pretty straightforward, and overall even easier tasks, I would say, than last week, other than the fact that the treasure hunt might have clipped a few people, and the fact that we have to use 150 purple jewels, which is a little bit of a waste on those. But other than that, as far as actual speed of getting them done, I would say that they were quite a bit quicker this week compared to last week, especially since one of them had a whole 1 day delay, since obviously you can't do 6 dungeons in a single week, but you can do 3, which is what we had as one of the options this week. So what do you get for doing all of this? So if you or free to play, pretty much nothing, as is most of these rewards. You get a difference between 5 HP up to 10 HP. Regardless if you're playing free to play or not, you will get that HP bonus. So that's probably the biggest benefit. Obviously, the actual loot that you get on this top area is pretty horrifically bad. As far as the bottom area, we get two unique new drops. One of them is a useless portrait. However, the other one is a new pet. This pet will be coming into the game a couple weeks or so after the campaign has finished. So you will be able to get at least one copy of this thing for free after the campaign at some point from an event corresponding to it. So no worries, you will be able to get this if you're playing free-to-play. It is cosmetic after all. However, it may be required for kingdom upgrades, things that come in through campaigns like this. So do be mindful of that, as there are already a two pet requirement kingdom upgrade being level 20, and there might be even higher ones going into the future. So do be mindful of that, but overall it's a cosmetic pet, so to that degree it is useless. And other than that, we get a portrait. This portrait will be available 3 months after its release, so whatever 3 months from pretty much right now, pretty much like any of the portraits, any of the titles, anything like that, comes in the same exact way, and it'll be available then. Anyways, that is pretty much everything to mention with this current campaign. We'll make sure to go over next week's one a little bit earlier than this one. But of course, these campaigns do not really have much of a time limit. Obviously, you have to complete them before the 10-week campaign is over. However, every single one of these earlier chapters have a really long amount of time frame as far as the time that you can get them done, because you can get them done in 2 weeks from now, 5 weeks from now, 6 weeks from now. As long as the 10-week campaign has not ended, you have all the time in the world to get these done. Obviously, you ideally want to do it the week of the event week. But you do theoretically have any amount of time, and we will be streaming these every single Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here on the YouTube channel, and we will be going over and doing all of them. That's when we normally do them, and then we cover a video a little bit later in the week, and it seems like it keeps going later and later, but we will go and cover the video a little bit earlier, hopefully, next week, and if nothing else, the Monday stream goes over in depth. But anyways, guys, I'll catch you guys soon. Thank you all so much for watching. Any other questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section below, and I will catch all of you guys soon. Goodbye, everyone!